Meghalaya, the abode of the clouds, is not only one of the most beautiful states in the northeast of India, it is also one of the states that has managed to successfully contain the spread of coronavirus. Hi everyone, I'm Kamya Jani from Curly Tales, and today on CT Cares, we'll be joined by the Chief Minister of Meghalaya, Mr. Conran Sangma, to talk about the measures taken by the government and how soon can we see normalcy returning. It's the first time a political representative is joining us on Curly Tales, so I'm particularly very excited about that. Mr. Sangma, thank you so much for joining in on Curly Tales. I'm very grateful that just before the outbreak, I managed to visit Meghalaya during the Meghalayan Age Festival, and it was good to see you enjoy the festival too.
It's nice. Very nice to hear that, and thank you so much for that.
So to begin with, I would like to congratulate you with the way the spread of coronavirus has been managed by the state. Since the outbreak, we've had about 44 confirmed cases in Meghalaya, out of which 25 have already been recovered. I mean, that speaks volumes about your management. If you can take us through the measures that were taken by the state to contain the spread.
First of all, of course, it has been quite a kind of a tough phase for everyone, the entire country and the world. In Meghalaya, just to give you the numbers, we actually had a total 43 cases. And out of the 43 cases, we have 31 who have recovered. And in fact, we have 32 recovered. And we only have about 10 active cases and one, of course, deceased. I think there are a number of factors that went into the overall management of a situation like this. And I think the quick response at the right time is, key to a lot of the situations we've seen throughout the world. To a large extent, India also closed its borders, and there was a lockdown and restricted movement. And I think that helped to a large extent. In Meghalaya, we started that a week before India did. And we closed our schools, we closed the assembly, we restricted movement of people. I guess we were right to a large extent. So that is number one, a decision that was very important. I think second was the fact that the data and the information of the people coming in, the data and information of whatever is happening around us, we kept it all centralized. And we made sure that we monitored all of that with the use of technology. I think number three, the most important is, I think, the active participation from all sections of society. So whether it's the politicians, whether it's the officers, and whether it's society, the most important was society, really played an important role. People participated. A lot of the people coming back to our state, all the tests that we have done, a large number of them, we have about 16,000 people who have come in. And we did not find many positive cases, even after having very stringent testing protocols in our state. So that's another, luck also has to do a lot with that. But I think good management was there. The officers have done an excellent job. And as I said, the society has been very, very supportive.
Well, that's absolutely commendable. And in fact, it is also believed that 2,000 contacts of the first COVID patient were traced within 18 hours. Is that true? Yes. And how did you make that possible?
Yes, that's true. We, in fact, there were a total of about 7,000 people at the end who we contact traced of the initial person who had the first in the index patient. And that, again, required a lot of our teamwork, and the surveillance officers had done an excellent job. The team, though it was a shock for us because we really were towards the end of the lockdown and we really didn't expect that. So I think everybody, including the hospital concerned, helped a lot. People responded when we flashed out in the news, asking people to call on a toll-free number and inform us if they have had any kind of contact with the concerned doctors or the hospital. So that really helped us a lot. And yes, the team worked very, very well and in a very efficient manner.
Absolutely. So you're under your leadership as well as the cooperation of the residents of Meghalaya. We believe that you've also introduced a behavior change model for living with COVID-19, which involves treating every resident as an asymptomatic carrier of the virus. So if you can shed more light on that as well.
Yes, I think in the current scenario, we all have to learn to live with COVID. So the way we feel that we would really change the behavior, because we've been talking about behavioral change. But somehow, you know, people find it difficult to understand sometimes what that means. So maybe the simplest way to change your behavior is actually when you think that you yourself are positive, what would you do to be careful for yourself and for your loved ones and anybody you're meeting? So I think telling yourself that you are an asymptomatic carrier, I think would make it very easy. So when I know that I'm a carrier, I know I need to wear a mask every time. Of course, we are online, so I'm not wearing a mask. But we would do that. And if I feel I'm an asymptomatic carrier, I would ensure I'm distancing myself from people. So I think if every single citizen starts thinking that they are asymptomatic, then automatically we don't have to tell them what to do, what not to do. They will themselves start behaving, changing their behavior. So it's really a very simple thing.
So this is clearly working very well in Meghalaya, and maybe other states should practice the same. But how have you been able to communicate this message to your citizens who have been, you know, abiding by your suggestion?
Yes, as I had mentioned in the beginning, from our side, the government has a role to play. Leadership has its role to play. The administration has their role to play. And then we have society in general. And the society means so many things, like the headmen's we have, and the religious groups we have, or the youth groups we have, the different NGOs. So I think when everybody came together and we had a presence at the grassroots level through religious organizations, through the headmen, it was easier for us to really message and get the information across to the people. So that network has helped us a lot. We have almost close to 7,000 COVID management committees in every village right now, every village. So any information we need to pass on to the 100 or 200 residents of a village, we pass it on to the headmen in local language, and they immediately disperse it to the people. So it's a very strong network that we've created, which is not something that we created, I should say. It has always been there, but we used it. We used that network and that trust to help us during this COVID time. And I think that has been very, very key and important to ensuring that the message reach to the people as fast as possible.
I'm so glad that this is working in favor of Meghalaya, because it is such a beautiful destination. And I believe it attracts over 1.3 million tourists every year. Tourism is one of the biggest industries as well for Meghalaya. If you can shed some light on the kind of impact COVID-19 has had on the state in terms of the tourism industry as well as employment.
I think COVID-19 has had quite a big impact on the economic scenario for the country as a whole, and Meghalaya is no different. So we did see a lot of economic activities being hit by basic things like farming or basic constructions that used to happen. And obviously tourism took a major hit in this. So therefore, it has been a big challenge for us. So Meghalaya has put up what we call an economic task force, and we have been looking at 7 different verticals where we have experts on board, and now we are coming out with interventions that will be necessary to really give a boost to the entire system. Small trucks and pickups and all those kind of things. And so we started using these youngsters and these people who had, and we became an aggregator for these transport system. And we connected the buyer to the seller. And through that, we created an opportunity. Now, imagine if you can upscale it to the whole state and in a massive way to all the other products. So I think it's important to really look at those opportunities that are coming out because of this COVID situation and take advantage of it. So similarly, in tourism also, we are doing that. We're calling it a COVID resilient tourism model. So we do hope that we'll be able to take advantage of that. Tourism is a big economy booster for us, and we feel that with Meghalaya having to a large extent been able to control the spread of this, would be seen as a safer destination. And if we can create a system for the tourists to come in and feel safe, and the people here to also feel safe that the tourist will not spread in case the person has some positive virus, I think that system can be created by having more structured. So we're still working on it.
Right. So innovation is the way to go. And recently, I also read, as per news reports, that anyone who wishes to visit Meghalaya will need government's permission. Is that right? And how is that going to work? You did mention about some protocols or SOPs that may, you know, that may come into place.
Yes, we are still taking it very, very slow and being very cautious. A lot of people are saying we're being overcautious, but I think in a situation like this, that is the only way to really protect you know, the people in the state at this point in time. So yes, it's a bit of inconvenience for people. But what we are trying to do is, number one, as I said, create a feeling of safety for everybody. When we are saying permit is required, it's not that, you know, you're going to go through a full interview process and it's going to take days of the permit. Absolutely not. It's for your safety and for the safety of the people. We are just simply saying you have to register and inform us. I think that is important, because that way we'll be able to give you the safety you deserve. At the same time, keep the people here safe. I feel strongly that a lot of states will slowly have to adapt, because otherwise it'll be very difficult to, until unless a vaccine comes, to really control the spread of this virus. So therefore, it is not meant to block anybody, but it's really a mechanism to create a safer environment for everyone.
Absolutely. And with the lockdown easing and as well as some relaxation of rules, how is it in Meghalaya right now? Is the interstate movement allowed? Are tourists allowed to come in or not as yet? Or are, what are the plans in terms of easing of the lockdown?
Well, we have eased the lockdown intrastate. That means within the state, we have eased it to a large extent, because we have been able to some extent, control the community spread. There's not been community spread, in fact, at all. And only the people who have come into the state, they have been detected with the virus. So that has been something positive for us. But what is important is that we can't let our guards down immediately. So therefore, till we are not able to come up with a proper system which will minimize the inconvenience for the tourist coming in, and maximize the safety for all the people here and the tourist, till that system is not there in place, we feel we need to be a bit slow, because it, you know, as we people say, it's better to be safe than be sorry. So we're going to open up for tourism very soon within the state. So a lot of people within the state also like to go to different resorts and spend a weekend with family. So we'll start with that. We'll see how the response is. So I think till that comfortness comes in and that feeling of safety comes into the local people also, because a lot of our places are rural-based tourism, I think it will be not correct for us to open up. So yes, it'll take some time.
Right. In fact, Prime Minister Modi, in his speech, said about going vocal for local, and that indicated a boost in domestic tourism. Is that something that you're looking for, that more Indians are going to look out for more destinations within the country instead of traveling abroad? And would you have any marketing campaigns around it to promote Meghalaya as a destination?
You're absolutely right. There are almost about 22 million Indians who go abroad every year. And I think these 22 million Indians will be looking for an alternative now. A lot of people will not. Some may still risk and say that, well, you know, we'll go and we'll still go to different parts of the world. But I think a lot will say, well, there are so many places within our country. So for this year, for next year, let's explore. So we are targeting those 22 million Indians who go abroad. That's number one. Number two, we are going to use this opportunity to upscale our tourism to some extent. So when you upscale it, then you are sending the message to people that the crowd is going to be lesser. It's going to be more of a high-end tourism. There's going to be better packaging for you. Activities are going to be defined. So I think this kind of a systematic and itinerary-based tourism, if we can develop and we can enhance the experience of the tourist, so we may need to increase the number of flights with smaller capacity, so that people, as I said, feel safer. So you may have group of three families saying that, okay, we are all fine. So three family, you know, the families and the whole member will come in one flight. Very, very, as I said, very specific and very tailor-made tourism activities. They would be going to a particular resort. They'll be told, well, next day, tomorrow morning, you'll be going for the trekking to this particular village. The villagers will know that these people are coming. So I think once we are able to do this kind of a very niche and a very target-based tourism and enhance the experience of the tourist out here, package it well, all very easy to say, but difficult to do. But I think we need to start somewhere. So this, we are planning on this, and we do hope that we'll be able to project Meghalaya as a COVID-safe and a high-end tourism destination.
Right, and I totally agree with you, because even through our show, I Love My India, we featured Meghalaya as one of the key destinations in India, which all Indians should definitely explore.
Thank you very much for that.
Okay. Before we let you go, you know, being the representative of the state and handling the current pandemic situation so well, is there anything that you would like to tell the other chief ministers or also the society in general about how we can try and contain the spread?
Yeah, I think number one, this is not an advice or anything I'm giving to anybody. I don't have a right to tell anybody that this is what you should do. But we have seen that once individuals take up the responsibility at their own level, then I think it is easier to fight this particular virus. So I think the message is for the citizens, not so much for the leadership, because every leader knows and is working in the best way they can. But I think it's important to look at oneself as a citizen and be responsible in your own way. And that is the reason why we've been stressing on this behavioral change and saying that simply behave as if you were a positive, asymptomatic carrier. It's not the government alone that can do this. This has to be a fight that the society and the country as a whole will have to take, and the whole world will have to take.
All right. And you know, we all have found a way to keep ourselves busy during the lockdown. I believe you've been playing the guitar. So would you be able to play that for our viewers now?
I'm sorry, I don't have a guitar right now, but maybe some other time I'll do that. But yeah, I think it's one thing I've been telling everybody, that that this entire situation of COVID has really, you know, been difficult. But I think it has really helped us and allowed us to spend time and give time to ourselves, to our loved ones, to our families, and to our hobbies. And I think make the best use of it. And you realize that you know, you're missing out on so many great things, which you know, got tied up with work and with this and that, and you forgot about it. So yeah, I'm enjoying this time to the extent I can. And whenever I get some free time, I spend with my children and with music, which we all love. So I'm sorry I'm not able to play. I'm in office right now. So I think it may become a news that Chief Minister is playing guitar while in office. So I don't think it's appropriate for me to do that now. But thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir, for taking out the time and sharing those wonderful insights. Stay safe.
You too. Thank you so much.